Hi there. In this video, we'll be learning to create a colorful folded paper cut effect in Illustrator. So let's get started. Let's create a 1920 by 1080 pixels document. And let's change the color mode to RGB and raster effects to 72 PPI. And hit create. Let's grab the rectangle tool and make a large rectangle covering the entire artboard. Double-click the fill option and pick a light color. I'm going to pick this shade and hit OK. Let's lock this layer from the layers panel and create another layer by clicking the small plus button at the bottom of the layers panel. Let's pick the text tool and pick a chunky font. I'm going to pick Poppins Black. Let's change the font size to 200 pixels for now. We might have to adjust it a little later. Now click anywhere on the artboard and type in your text. I'm going to type in layer in capital letters. We definitely need to increase the size of the text, so let's click the corner handle on the right and holding shift, drag to increase the font size. I think this size should be good enough for our illustration. Now hit Command C on a Mac or Control C on a PC to make a copy of the text, and then hit Command F on a Mac or Control F on a PC to paste it in front. Now you see we have the copy of the text, so leaving the first letter, delete the rest. With the letter selected, click the fill option and change the color to white. Now place the white L on top of the black L. Ensure that the smart guides are on so that it becomes easier to place the letters on top. Similarly, make another copy of the text and this time leaving the letter A, delete the rest and then place the letter on top of the black A. Do this for the rest of the letters as well. Once you have masked all the black letters with white letters, go to the Layers panel, locate the black text, which should ideally be the first sublayer, select it, and hit the trash icon to delete the word, leaving you with just the white individual letters. I think the letter A is too close to the letter L, so let's do a little bit of kerning and move it to the right. Select the first letter L, and let's show the swatches panel first. So let's go to Window and select Swatches. With the letter L selected, select None from the Swatches panel, at which point the letter L shall turn invisible. But don't worry, we'll get it back soon enough. Let's show the Appearance panel now, and you can find it under Window. So let's go to Window, and there you can see the Appearance panel is already ticked, which means it's already showing here. Ah, there it is. So let's drag it out. Let's create more room in the panel as it's about to get busy. You see the invisible letter L is still selected, so click the Add New Fill button at the bottom of the Appearance panel to add a fill, and you shall find the letter L back in business. Only this time it's black in color. Click the small arrow of the fill option to reveal more colors, and select the black and white gradient option. Once the gradient is selected, double-click the left color stop of the gradient and enter 146 for red, 40 for green, and 143 for blue, and hit enter. Now click the right color stop once and change its location to 80%. Double-click the color stop and enter 159 for red, 31 for green, and 99 for blue, and hit enter. Make sure that your colored letter is still selected and go to Effect, and then Stylize, and select Drop Shadow. Change the mode to Normal, Opacity to 10%, X Offset to 5 pixels, Y Offset to 0 pixel, and blur to 10. Also ensure that the color is set to black, which is R0, G0, and B0. and then hit OK. Now come out of the drop shadow panel with the letter still selected, add another fill by clicking the Add New Fill button at the bottom of the Appearance panel. Change the fill to black and white gradient, much like we did earlier. Now double click the left color stop and enter 159 for red, 31 for green, and 99 for blue, and hit enter. Select the right color stop and change its location to 75%. Now double click the stop and enter 218 for red, 28 for green, and 91 for blue, and hit enter. Basically, this is a lighter shade of gradient, and we're going to use this as the folded cutout. The fill we created earlier was a darker gradient, something we'll use as the shadow. Since our gradient angle is set to zero already, we don't need to change that. With the letter still selected, go to Effect, and then Distort and Transform, and select Free Distort. Drag those right points as illustrated. So this is how we can give the letter the folded look, as if the letter is a cutout and is folded. So once you have dragged the points, hit OK. And you shall find the letter L with lighter gradient folded. But the job is not done yet. We need to add darker shadows that would form right behind the folded or raised letter. So to do that, let's add another fill the same way we added the other two. Now, since we want the darker shadow to appear between the folded and flat letters, let's drag this new fill between the two fills. Select this new fill and double-click the color stop on the left and update the RGB values to 0 and hit enter. Now click the color stop on the right and drag it to the 100% location, which is the extreme right corner, and then double-click it and update the RGB values to 0 and hit enter. Now change its opacity to 40%. Next, go to Effect and then Distort and Transform and select Free Distort. Drag the points on the right, much like we did earlier, and hit OK. At this point, you could find the black shadow appearing behind the letter, which we faked using the black fill. Now, with the black fill selected, click the small plus button at the bottom of the appearance panel to duplicate this fill. With the duplicated fill selected, change the opacity to 30%. Now, go to Effect, and then Distort and Transform. And this time, let's select Transform. Change the horizontal move to 5 pixels and hit OK. With the same black fill selected, go to Effect and then Blur and select Gaussian Blur and enter 5 pixels as the radius and hit OK. What this does is it makes the shadow a little more realistic and adds a slight transition from the dark shadow to the lighter tone. Now the good news is that our difficult task is over. All we need to do is to copy the effects to the rest of the letters and change their top and bottom gradient colors. The easiest way to do that is through the Layers panel. Expand the layer and you'll notice a little circle on the right side of all the objects. When I say circle, I don't mean the red dot, but the one just left to it. Holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, click and drag it to paste the attributes to the next letter. The moment the attributes are copied, you shall find the next letter, which in our case is the letter A, inherits the same gradient colors. Select the letter A from the Layers panel. You'll have to click the same circle you clicked to copy the attributes to select it. Now all we need to update is the fill on top and bottom. So select the fill on top and then double click the color stop on the left and enter 238 for red, 28 for green, and 37 for blue, and hit enter. Now double click the color stop on the right and enter 241 for red, 90 for green, and 65 for blue, and hit enter. Let's select the bottom fill and then double click the color stop on the left and enter 190 for red, 31 for green, and 46 for blue. And hit enter. Now double-click the color stop on the right and enter 238 for red, 28 for green, and 37 for blue. And hit enter. The location has slightly moved while double-clicking, so let's select it and change it back to 80%. Next, let's copy the attributes of this letter to the next letter from the Layers panel, and then select the letter. Now, select the fill on top and double-click the left color stop and enter 249 for red, 105 for green, and 8 for blue, and hit enter. Similarly, double-click the color stop on the right and enter 254 for red, 183 for green, and 21 for blue, and hit enter. The location for this one has also slightly moved while double-clicking, so let's select it and change it back to 75%. Let's select the bottom fill and double-click the left color stop and enter 241 for red, 89 for green, and 66 for blue, and hit enter. Now double-click the color stop on the right and enter 249 for red, 105 for green, and 8 for blue, and hit enter. Time to copy the attributes to the next letter from the Layers panel, and then select the letter. Go to the top fill and double-click the left color stop and enter 0 for red, 148 for green, and 70 for blue, and hit enter. Now double-click the right color stop and enter 111 for red, 191 for green, and 78 for blue, and hit enter. The location is slightly moved yet again while double-clicking, so let's select it and change it back to 75%. Now select the bottom fill and double-click the left color stop and enter 0 for red, 110 for green, and 59 for blue, and hit enter. Now double-click the right color stop and enter 0 for red, 148 for green, and 70 for blue, and hit enter. Also update the location to 80%. Copy the attributes to the next letter one last time using the Layers panel, and then select the letter. Now select the top fill and double-click the left color stop and enter 27 for red, 117 for green, and 188 for blue, and hit enter. Let's also update the location to 0%. Now double-click the right color stop and enter 39 for red, 170 for green, and 225 for blue, and hit enter. Finally, select the bottom fill and double-click the left color stop and enter 43 for red, 57 for green, and 144 for blue, and hit enter. Now double-click the right color stop and enter 27 for red, 117 for green, and 188 for blue, and hit enter. And there you go, guys. The folded paper cut text effect is ready. Alright guys, I hope you've enjoyed the video and have learned something new from it. So do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.